Lecture 6 quiz review is on cell biology, and this is the last lecture of all of the organization lectures, and this is where a lot of the transition starts happening into some of the harder lectures as well, and so just be aware of that as you move forward with some of the other lectures. Now, most of your questions will be on all of the organelles that we discussed, like what you're seeing right here, from the nucleus to the ribosome, Golgi apparatus, all the way down the list. That's where most of your questions are at. But there are some other questions that are a little more unique. So let me go through those here real quick. Everyone will get a question on the common features to all cells. Now, the way in which I describe this can actually vary, but sometimes I say which of the following is not a common characteristic to both prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells. If you remember, we talked about how prokaryotic and eukaryotic, those are the only two types of cells. So that's basically asking which of the following is not a common characteristic to all cells. And that throws people off sometimes. They're like, I don't get what you're asking. Well, there's only two types of cells in the world, prokaryotic and eukaryotic. So if I say which of the following is not a common feature to both prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells, it's the same question as saying what is not one of these common features to all cells. So make sure you know these six. Sometimes I may say which of the following is a feature that is only found in eukaryotic cells. Generally, when I do that one, I do the nucleus because that is one of the defining characteristics of a eukaryotic cell. Prokaryotic cells do not have a nucleus. Again, coming back to this picture right here, there's a prokaryotic cell. It has its DNA and everything, but it doesn't have a nucleus like plant and animal cells have. That is one of the most obvious features of a eukaryotic cell. So there's a couple of ways in which I'll describe or ask it, but generally it's from this list of six here. So make sure you know that these are all the characteristics of all cells. That's one question. Second question, we'll actually get into connections that cells make with one another. Though we're not going to talk about tissues in this class in biology, I want you to at least be aware of how cells interact with one another. And so you have to know the difference between tight junctions, anchoring junctions, gap junctions, and plasmodesmata. Those are the plant junctions that are essentially used for sharing fluid, and it's part of their vascular system. It's used in nectar secretion and all of that. So make sure you can define the difference between a tight anchoring and gap, and the examples that I used in the lecture are ones that I use on the quiz, as well as the plasmodesmata. Those are all belonging to the same grouping of questions, meaning you only get one of that, but you got to know all four of them because you don't know which question you're going to get from those four. All the other questions are gone on these organelles that we talked about, especially the ones that that have their own lectures, like chloroplasts and mitochondria and such. So make sure you know not only what belongs to the endomembrane system, that's one possible question, but also what each of their individual roles are. You can bet that if you've got your own lecture on them, chloroplasts is lecture 8 and mitochondria is lecture 9, you can bet they're going to show up on the quiz. So make sure you know chloroplasts and mitochondria. Little tip to understand too is these have their own DNA along with the nucleus. There is one possible question where I ask which organelles don't have any of their own DNA. Nucleus, chloroplasts, and mitochondria all have their own DNA. Anything else, that none of those other organelles have their own DNA. So make sure you know that as well. Lysosomes is such an important one. You can guarantee you're going to have a question on that. All these other ones, peroxisomes, vacuoles, smoothie R, Golgi apparatus, you're not guaranteed to have questions on them. They're grouped together in such a way that it randomizes which one you get, but you got to know all of them because you don't know which one you're going to get. So chloroplasts, mitochondria, lysosomes, you're guaranteed to get a question on each one of those, and then look for questions on these other ones. Generally, I'll describe what they're involved in, what their role is, you know, how they work, their application, as we've talked about it during the lecture. Cytoskeleton, this is one where even though we go through the various parts of the cytoskeleton, like the microtubules, microfilaments, intermediate filaments. You won't have questions that will test you individually on those parts. It'll just be on the cytoskeleton. But do make sure you know and remember which parts these are involved in, because that's going to be part of the question where I describe their role. Okay. Things like mitochondria, again, this is involved in energy production. There are questions on how defects in this organelle can affect certain human problems like ALS and neurodegenerative disorders and muscular dystrophies. It's not the cause of all of them, but there are a lot of disorders associated with mitochondrial problems. This is also, again, the mitochondrial DNA is what's inherited from mother to child. It's not passed on from the father. This is maternal inheritance. This is actually what they use to look down your maternal line when they're doing DNA testing and things of that sort. When you get to things like Tay-Sachs disease or adrenal leukodystrophy, make sure you know which organelle they are associated with, because that comes up on the quiz as well. Generally, most of the questions are either examples or the function of how these work. One that people usually miss all the time is that the smooth ER makes phospholipids. And when I talk about a cell growing and enlarging and getting bigger, and which organelle is responsible for making more of the cell membrane, people always choose cell membrane, and it's wrong. It's the smooth ER. The smooth ER makes the phospholipids that enlarges the cell membrane. Okay, so make sure you don't confuse the organelle that makes the phospholipids with the membrane, the cell membrane that is part of the outer part of the cell. Now, the cell membrane can also be a quiz question. Make sure you know what the cell membrane does, because it's an organelle, just like the skin is an organelle or organ of the human body. So again, that's why these parallels, is because organelles have these individual functions, just like organs of the body have these individual functions. The cell membrane, remember, is that barrier that's selective about what goes in and out. It's hydrophobic. It has a mosaic of proteins in it. So these are things to all look out for and make sure you are familiar with for the quiz. Okay. So you're not guaranteed to have one question on every single organelle, but some you're going to have a question on, like chloroplasts and mitochondria or lysosome. The cell wall is also one that you'll have a question on, because we bring it up so many times. Make sure you know that chitin is the cell wall of fungi, and cellulose is the cell wall of plants, and that peptidoglycan, that's a strange one, but that's the cell wall of bacteria. We bring that up all the time, especially when we talk about antibiotics destroying bacteria and destroying their cell wall. That's why I bring up these examples, because they make sense later on. So you're not guaranteed to have one on every single one, but expect, you know, that you'll have it on almost all of them, okay? So that should help you out with quiz 6.